GNAP Project Manager Introduction, Part 2 of 2. The next component to build is Input Sources, since it is the layer above Unicode. We use the same procedure as for Unicode to create the project file and load it into GPS as shown here. However, this project is not yet configured. What's missing is a dependency on the Unicode layer. To add the required dependency, right-click on Input Sources Lib from the context menu, select Project Dependencies. In the Project Dependencies window, use Add from File to find and select the unicodelib.gpr file, then click Apply. The Unicode library now appears at the bottom of the project view. We are now in a position to build the static library for input sources. After building the project files with the remaining library components, the entire XML Ada library from Schema to Unicode looks like this. Note that building Schema lib will, if necessary, also build the components it depends on. The Ada compiler doesn't require a makefile. Therefore, building Schema lib ensures that all five library files are created. However, in production, it is probably more desirable to have a single library file than five separate ones. To accomplish that objective, let's create a project file at the XML Ada level and give it visibility to all sources. Note that the GNAT Project Manager supports the notion of an aggregate of library projects. However, the GUI to the project file does not currently support this feature, and so we will use the conventional means. From the menu bar, run the project/new command and then select Library Project. This screenshot shows the information provided to the GNAT Project Manager in order to create a project file that produces a single static library file. The GUI to the project file is opened from the menu bar with the command project/edit project properties and looks like this. Much of this information was entered during the workflow process to create the initial state of the project file. However, once the project file exists and is loaded into GPS, we can make additional changes using this interface. For the selected language or languages, we can specify the required toolchain and details thereof. This is important when maintaining different versions of the code base for various customers whose environments differ with regard to the compiler, linker, and debugger. GNAT test is used together with AUnit to provide the regression testing framework for the units in a project. The body of the unit tests are stubbed out and must therefore be implemented by the developer. Nevertheless, thanks to GNAT test, anything that can be generated is generated, and this saves a huge amount of time and effort. The Source Files tab allows us to see all sources in the project. If the Source Files box is checked, we have the ability to add and remove selected units. CodePeer is an advanced static analysis tool that is used to find potential bugs before the code is executed. Some mixed language and/or multiple platform applications are built using a makefile. This field simply allows you to pass the makefile to the GNAT Project Manager. GNAT Check is a tool used to check the source code against coding standard rules. This window allows you to select an existing coding standard file or create a new one. The field at the bottom displays the rules currently in effect. In this example, no rules have been defined, and hence the field is empty. You may have noticed an empty panel in the bottom right of each properties window called Scenario. This panel serves to display something called scenario variables, which allow us to control the behavior of a project. To illustrate, let's change the behavior of the XML Ada project to allow creation of a static or dynamic library depending on the state of the environment variable library type. To begin, run the command tools/views/scenario, and in the scenario panel, right-click and run add configuration variable. The other steps are illustrated in screenshots 3 and 4. Then, in the project properties GUI, check the box next to dynamic in the scenario panel of the library window and change the library kind to dynamic. Then OK the changes to update the project file. In the main window, run project/saveall. Then, in the scenario panel, which has been moved to a more convenient location, make sure the library type variable is set to dynamic, then run build all. As you can see, by modifying the project file with the scenario variable, we can now selectively create a dynamic library. One is not limited to just one scenario variable. You could introduce another variable, for example build, having two enumerated values, debug and production, to configure the project to support these separate activities. If you're curious, you can open the xmlada.gpr project file in a text editor to see what it looks like. The GNAT Programming Studio provides a graphical user interface to create GNAT project files suitable for most software development environments. There are, however, a few applications that require advanced features of the GNAT Project Manager which are not supported by the user interface. For such cases, it is necessary to manually edit parts of the project file, and this requires a deeper understanding of the GNAT Project Manager facility. For those interested, a comprehensive follow-up tutorial has been provided to explore the advanced features of the GNAT Project Manager. This is the end of the GNAT Project Manager, an introduction tutorial.